welcome everyone to the broadcast table. Chris Webber to my right, Greg Anthony to my left. I'm Kevin Harlan, and David Aldridge on our sideline. Here we are in November. Let's see how things are shaking out in the West early in the season. Take a look at the Warriors. They're in second, looking to take over the first spot.
And well, for the Warriors, they had a few critics coming into the season, and now I don't think they have any. This is a club ready to not only make a deep run, but possibly win it all.
You know, that's the mindset you have to have. They know if they can get to the playoffs, they have the talent to do some real damage.
And a look at the starters for the Hornets. Jamichael Green is out there with Damari Carroll. Then there's Hernan Gomez. Then it's White. And it's Lamb at the two. And for the Warriors, they've got Jones. Steph Curry's out there with Curry. Then there's Draymond Green. And it's McKinney in at the three slot. Looking at teams with new coaches, Chris, how long do you think it usually takes a new system to get the kinks out and work properly?
Yeah, hopefully you have veteran players because they can adapt the system a little bit quicker. Younger players, they might not, you know the lingo. They might not know necessarily where to be. So you have to practice. And with practice time not being as a premium like it used to be, it's a little tougher. So it takes a while. You want to make sure you kind of look at the season, 82 games. You look at them in four 20-game stretches. And you hope by that second 20-game stretch, you're into finding your rhythm as a team and the team starting to hone in on those little details.
Good perspective.
And a wide open look for Lamb. And again, Charlotte with the triple.
The work Lamb has put into this part of his game is evident. Getting better at sniping from deep.
On its way from Curry for two. And that comes off the assist by Jones. Curry's got five now.
And just a step ahead of the D in that possession there, making the pass. Nice assist.
And Lamb kicks to Carroll. Pass to Hernan Gomez. Charlotte moving the ball around. Here's Lamb. Shot clock at six. And that one off the back of the rim and in.
Executing the plan here early. Still haven't missed a shot.
Outside Curry. Fires for three. Score it. His third straight basket in three tries.
He can wow you with his passes. I mean, that's as good of a pass as any three-pointer Curry's going to hit.
Hornets have gotten their first three shots to go in for him to start off this game. White finds Green. Carroll with it. Now Green defending. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. The Hornets shooting their first free throws here for the night.
And they had a lot of success a season ago as a team, hitting about 80% of their free throws.
And the first one drops.
Yeah, and the Hornets, they had a very strong bench, not only with their scoring, but how they impact rebounding and passing. I mean, one of the better benches in this league.
That one misses. And the Hornets have had a strong bench for a while now.
Yeah, depth isn't a problem for this team. Having a formidable starting five, though, has been. They need to consider trading some depth for an upgrade at the starting position.
Here's Lamb. The Warriors making the shot. And Jones sends it back, and he gets it back. That one drops for him. That's 7 points for Lamb. For the Warriors, they won their last contest, that game against San Antonio.
In that one, they owned the backboard. Most of the second-chance opportunities went to them.
Yeah, if you can be that much better on the glass, you're going to win the game.
White drives in. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
Yeah, under control. White has those short, quick strides.
Fires top of the key, and the Warriors count on two more.
And he delivers another blow. Something's gotten into him this quarter. He's carrying them offensively.
Pass to Lamb. Back to White. 107 left here in the opening quarter. No good from Lamb.
Oh, man, as good of a shooter as he is, it drives him crazy to miss a wide-open three like that.
And a deep three from Curry. Hernan Gomez grabs the miss. The Hornets trail. Right drive Lamb. Jacks up a three. Bangs home the trifecta.
But really, Lamb, he's a jack-of-all-trades kind of player. A superb passer with good instincts.
Here's Curry with the three, and a great assist by Curry. That one goes in. Curry's got four assists now tonight. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. On the wing, Lamb. Three-pointer. Draymond Green with the rebound. Looking at the last game for Charlotte, it was a loss to the Kings in Sacramento. Curry's shot is good. Curry's got 18 points.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give them from behind the arc.
Lamb against Curry. Over to the left wing. White. Curry was a nice dude.
They just took that possession off. I mean, they get away with it that time, but they've got to show some more aggression.
A free-flowing first quarter. Great scoring through one. Warriors lead by 5. The second quarter coming up right after this break, so don't go anywhere. And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. And from what we've seen so far from the Warriors, how would you grade them?
Just stretching out the floor that first, they had the defense scrambling.
But just wearing them out. I mean, when you space the floor like this, the defense has to run and expend energy.
Warriors leading by 5. In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. Setting the floor for the Warriors. We've got Steph Curry, Udo out there with Evans, and it's Poole in at the shooting guard. And with all the numbers that Curry puts up, all the records, Chris, that he owns, crazy to think that he's often sitting in the fourth quarter due to the score.
Yeah, it is crazy, Kevin. I mean, you pick Curry's MVP season, and even then he wasn't playing. That is a testament to just how incredible he is. Curry finds ways to end games even before it reaches the fourth.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Charlotte's had to wait a bit the last few years. Now, the city hosted the All-Star game last season. But for the Hornets, they've gone 3 seasons without a playoff appearance and 15 seasons without winning a playoff series. In that time, the franchise has had 7 head coaches and a shifting front office. The Buzz City is hoping that its wait for playoff relevance will end soon. Kevin?
We all are. David, thank you. Here's Curry, following the basket by Malik Monk. From deep. But they get it back. Udo, the pass to Pastor. From deep, 3-point range. Curry can't get it to go. Hornets trail by 6. Bridges kicks to Batum. The pass to Zeller. Biombo with it. You don't want him. Pocket 6. But no one around him. They grab their own miss. Batum, good.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Outside Curry. Connects from 3-point range. Curry's got 8 points here in this quarter. Well, if teams are getting shaken up a bit, coach is usually the first to go, get fired. Do you think teams get too trigger-happy with that aspect, coach first and then looking at the team?
Yeah, I do. But unfortunately, if you're the head of the team, that's the responsibility, and that's kind of that's your job, to take all of the heat. Being a coach is such a thankless job. You don't get thanked unless you win the championship. If not, it's like, good job, okay. We don't care about the fires you put out. We don't care about the players you develop. We don't care about the chemistry you built. You didn't win. So, yeah, coaches are usually the first to go, and it's unfair. But hopefully they have some connections and they have a good resume, and they'll be back around somewhere else. They'll pop up somewhere else.
They sure will. And with Cody Zeller, he has a very workmanlike approach when he's on the floor.
Yeah, Kevin, and that's what Zeller is all about, playing a simple meat and potatoes type game. I mean, what he does won't show up in the box score, but it'll show up in the standings.
break in the action, let's show you the teams with the most second chance points last year.
That's an effort stat for me. I mean, it shows you how hard this team works in the paint. They continue to pound the backboard.
Warriors leading by four. Here in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. And Poole gets it to go.
The defense a step slow. You can see the result.
Out to the right wing. On its way from Monk for two. And it falls over the rim and in. Monk's got six.
And he has really come to life here after a slow start in that first quarter.
Here's Green, and there are the Warriors now with another bucket.
Reliable from the mid-range area. Green with good awareness, and he seizes the opportunity.
Outside, White. Outside, Batum. Just five on the clock. Bridges for three, and it's the Hornets another three.
This is the kind of teammate Batum is. You like seeing him share it like this.
Passes it to Pascal. Green deciding where to go with it. And they come right back with their own three-point. Green's got his second basket.
For real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
Talk about great competition going on. That's what makes a matchup like this so much fun to watch.
And unfortunately, we've seen a few too many of those. A lack of concentration, a turnover, and an easy bucket in transition.
Here's Monk. Outside, White from downtown. Sinks the triple. He's got five.
An assertive offensive player. White knows he has the green light to rise and fire.
And so it's the home team with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter. From beyond the arc, they've been absolutely tremendous. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Steph, I know Coach Stress is taking care of the basketball. What have you guys been doing to make sure you limit your turnovers?
But it's just about an in-game situation. It's just analyze the situation and take care of the ball. Making sure that your man got in contact with the passes. And, sometimes getting a shot up is better than giving it to them. So we got to just look at that and figure it out.
Yeah, when you don't turn the ball over, you have a chance to score, right? Congratulations. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is right here. Say hey to the folks, Kenny.
Hey, folks.
Say hey to the folks, Shaq.
Hey, folks.
Hey, let's get this party started. Well, for the Warriors, Kenny, what do you think?
Well, they showed a lot of discipline on offense. Called some high-percentage plays. Even when the defense devised different looks, they always seem to have the answer. That's good coaching.
Shaq, let's get your insight on Charlotte.
Their defense has been practically non-existent. Sure, they faced a team that got hot. You could even say a bit lucky at times. But no one is stepping up on D and taking anything away. Have some pride. Don't let a guy shoot like that in your face.
That's all for now. Say goodbye to the folks.
Thanks
goodbye
for
joining us. Third quarter, just about ready to begin.
We saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. Curry has been sensational.
Yeah, he's just been raining down on them from deep here. Talk about dialed in.
Oh, man, what a tremendous first half. Okay, obviously he's feeling the flow, and he's looking to keep it going.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. And Charlotte looking at who they've got. Jeremy Lamb out there with White. Then it's Damari Carroll. Then there's Hernan Gomez. And it's Green in at the four. Hornets trail by nine.
Well, everyone is already agreeing that Curry is a generational talent. And one of the greatest shooters of all time. I mean, at this point, he is just climbing up the all-time list in NBA history. I mean, what a robust resume.
And here is Curry following Jeremy Lamb's three. On the wing, Lamb for the three. And Jones pulls it down. And here's Green. He'll bring it up for the Warriors. They've led by as much as 10. And with Curry, the title is the unanimous MVPs. Chris, it's hard to argue he's not one of the best ever.
Yeah, Kevin, what stands out to me is just how much he's changed the game. I mean, when you alter how teams approach the game and how kids practice at home, he's made the three just as big as the dunk. It's still early, but a 1-for-4 start to the half, that's a bad sign if you ask me. If they've got a can't-miss play, now's the time to break the glass and pull it out.
He's found his rhythm from deep, and you can see the confidence.
To him, Greg, the basket looks as big as the ocean right now. I mean, that's how easy he's making it look. And they're going to have to pay closer attention to him beyond the arc. I mean, he's got 2 threes in this half, a total of 3 overall.
Timeout called the Warriors.
You feel like Jeremy Lamb has been in the league forever, mostly known for being a piece in the Harden trade when he left OKC, but Lamb is coming to his own the last few years. Season he played outstanding. Second in free throw percentage, fourth in 3-point field goal percentage, and as one of the NBA's top 5 scorers, you also can't forget what an outstanding year he had offensively.
And back to his free throw shooting percentage, second in the league. I never saw lapses in his concentration at all. Always completely focused, completely automatic. And so here's Charlotte after the Warriors pick up 3. Pass to Biombo. Jones against Lamb. Over in the corner, Green has to carry. 4 on the clock. Off target from outside. Warriors leading by 12. Green finds Curry. And Curry with the stuff.
That's the thing that Green makes look way easier than it is. You gotta have amazing vision to make that pass.
Curry brings the double. The pass to Curry. Here's Biombo, defended by Jones. Good! 15 points for Lamb. We're talking about number one options at the offensive end. There's a mentality, right, that you've got to have as the team's go-to scorer, isn't there?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Let's look at Harden. He can go 0-for-7, and then he expects to go 27-for-27. How about Curry? Have you ever seen Thompson when they said, oh, my God, Klay Thompson is off. Last game, he only had 11 points. Well, when that happens, you can bet your last dollar that the next game, he's going to make every shot. And so what it is again, a short memory. Whether you make a lot, so what? I'm going to do that again tonight. And if you missed a lot the previous night, so what? That wasn't this night. Let's get it right now.
So Charlotte calls timeout. They're first. Curry with a strong contribution so far in this one.
They got to start guarding him out to about 28 feet because he's killing from long range.
Charlotte. Cody Zeller's checked in for Jermichael Green. Miles Bridges comes in for Damari Carroll. Nicholas Batum, he's checked in for Jeremy Lamb. And it's Malik Monk in for White. That one's in there. The Warrior lead is cut down now to just 11 on the basket for Batum. Curry way outside. The long distance three is buried. Curry's got 14 points for the game.
The defense is far too slow to close out on those three-point attempts.
The shot by Monk is no good. Warriors leading by 14. From deep.
Oh, and it goes in! How do you stop that?
You can't.
How do you stop that?
You cannot. Batum passes to Biombo. Now, here's Batum. He's got 8. Monk for 3. And the 3-ball is good. 9 points in the game so far.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
Well, these days, so much emphasis on the perimeter game. But you can see why after that sequence.
Fires the 3. The Hornets keeping it alive. The new 14. And the rejection by Udo. Bridges gets the Monk. Bridges, no one around him. No luck, they battle on the glass, but couldn't knock it down. And so it's the home team, sitting with a comfortable lead up by 14. And if they keep draining the threes like they've been so far, their lead is safe. Right back after this break. Fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. Hornets trail by 14. They've got Evans, and it's Pascal in at the 4 spot. Batum passes to Monk. The 19-foot shot. It's rebounded by Udo.
A little surprise he took the jump shot with nobody around him. He could have attacked the basket.
And the shot is good.
Yes, sir.
Charlotte shooting, certainly a key for them in this one. 55% from the field. Monk for 3. It's no good. He's now 4 of 9 from the field. Warriors leading by 16. And Poole gets it to go.
Good anticipation on the feed. He knows exactly where to go with that ball.
To the wing on the left. Monk for 3. Make it 5 for 10 with him in that bucket.
And Monk has proven that he is a terrific scorer from the perimeter. When he's in rhythm, he has no problem letting it fly.
Here's Poole. From deep 3-point range, it's rebounded by Charlotte. Here's Monk. Doesn't get it to drop for him. Evans with some nice deep. Deep. Poole, no good. Hornets trail by 15. Monk for 3. And it's the Hornets, another 3.
I tell you, Monk can fill it up in a hurry. Well, once he gets on fire, the D knows they're going to be in for a long night.
Here's Poole. From deep 3-point range, Batum grabs the miss.
He missed that one, but I've seen him drill shots from that distance in warm-up.
Yeah, and I have too, which is why they're okay with it. I'm sure if he gets that kind of look again, he's going to let it fly again.
Timeout called the Warriors.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
Poor rotations, I mean, slow help, and just not enough toughness on the interior. They've got a lot to talk about.
for Charlotte. Jamichael Green, he's checked in for Zeller. Damari Carroll comes in for Miles Bridges. Jeremy Lamb's checked in for Nicholas Batum. And it's wide in for Malik Monk. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Alderman.
Hey, guys. I was able to catch the message Steve Kerr gave to his team. He said, I love how we're shooting the basketball. You guys have been locked in from three. Just keep taking makeable shots. If you don't have it, pass it to the guy who does. Kevin?
Now here's Green, and Green slams it in.
And the second chance becomes a dunk. We could feel over here.
GA, such a good, aggressive play in the paint. Hits it from three-point range. Chris, middle of last season, plenty of drama around the AD trade request. Davis wanting to leave New Orleans. Some say all publicity is good publicity. But Commissioner Silver clearly does not agree.
I don't agree either, and I think if you go back, the Lakers would say that's a self-inflicted wound. And some things are best left in the locker room. Let me tell you this. Every team tried to trade for AD except the team that didn't have him last year, and maybe the Golden State Warriors. So everyone was out there. It just wasn't the rumors. And so, no, you never really like those rumors. They affect young players. They affect the player that may be being traded for. They affect the home fan base. They affect everyone. So you want to try to keep all of that in-house. Some things are better left than said.
And there's no doubt about this one. Playing with a lot of confidence tonight. It's a statement victory for the Warriors.
And the big difference here was accuracy from three-point range.
And once they started sinking shots, it really stretched out the D and created other opportunities. And anytime they got space, they seemed to just knock down another triple.
And so with this win, they'll move to six victories on the season.
And with the win approaching, they'll take the first game here of two that they'll play against this team. Nice to get that first one out of the way and set the tone.
The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for Champ.
He was the one dictating the pace tonight, playing up tempo or slowing it down, but always scoring.
Carroll kicks to White. Warriors with the rebound. Curry attacking, and he makes good on the layup.
They made the most of their opportunities, looking comfortable and locked in throughout the night.
That's why they're in the driver's seat right now, looking to put this one away.
So we see the Warriors get the win here. A confident win, and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here at home. I think they built off that edge of being here and playing with just a little more confidence than their opponent.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Alden, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long, everyone.